where equality is just another euphemism for mediocrity, where participation is more highly valued than achievement, where just enough to get by is the new standard of excellence. There is a small minority of people who fight back against such apathy, who struggle daily to reach new heights. These brave few are the hope for the future, the bright shining light for the next generation. They are the ones who will lead us to the places we have never dreamed of, to the undiscovered country, to reach goals only a few can even begin to imagine. Unfortunately, none of those people could be here tonight, so kick back and relax. Prepare yourself for several hours of fun, friendship, fascinating conversation, and fabulous music. All those F's, that's an alliteration and kind of a radio trick. Speaking of radio, you're listening to the most popular radio station in the history of broadcast radio, at least among stations that originate from Chris's living room. It's Curious Times. Your host is a curious listener. Here she is, Chris.
All right. Yay. Thank you. Hold your applause, please. Welcome. Welcome, everybody, to Curious Times. It's, oh, my God. It just sneaks up on me like that. It is. Happy birthday to my mother. Yay. It's September 22nd, Saturday, and Corrine DeWinter is here. And so this is good. We have a guest. And I could even post a picture tonight. I got control back of all my files. I don't know what that's all about. It's craziness. It doesn't look like we got another show happening until Wednesday after this. Don't know what happened to Salva yesterday, but it is what it is, what it is, what it is. So anyhow, all of you guys know Corrine, but I know that we'll be uploading to some other platforms and YouTube, and so for the benefit of any new listeners, Corrine DeWinter is an amazing person, actually. I know, I'm sure you think I say that about everybody, but she is, and she is so multi-talented. She's like she's a psychic medium. Big deal, right? She is also an award-winning author. She's an artist. She owns her own business called www.purpleplates.com. She makes jewelry. She is very much involved with charity work, and oh, so much more. And she has them boots that are made for walking, and that's just what they do. And but Corrine is also a radio show host of her own show for a number of years now, called Supernatural Radio on Blog Talk Radio. And she, what the heck else is that she does? There's something else that I was going to say. Oh, paranormal. She's been like and then she's also like a video star. And she was like a murderer and a video star in a video. It was very, very, it took extreme amount of acting talent for Corrine to, such a nice, gentle, soft woman to portray a psychotic murderer in a music video. But she's also done that, so add that to your resume, you know. Anyway, you can find out more about her at www.corrinedewinter.com. Go find her Purple Plates, www.purpleplates.com, where you can find a plethora of energy products, including the world-famous Purple Plates. And she has all kinds of crystals, and she makes her own perfume. Oh my goodness, Ostera. Get yourself some Ostera. Please trust me when I tell you that. Watch this. It's just going to... Oh my God. I can't even stand it when it... because I don't even know. It's amazing. See, it just like changes. It just changes. Like it just... I'm totally zen now. Anyhow, what else do I need to do? That's about all I want to say. Let's just go get the woman and find out what the heck's going on with Corrine DeWinter. How you doing, Corrine?
Okay. It sounds a little bit fuzzy. Do you hear like a background noise, Chris?
No, I don't. I mean, no.
Okay.
I mean, when
I don't,
like, when
I didn't
you,
know.
Everybody's okay. Everybody's okay. It's all in your head, Corrine. Like whatever it is.
Okay, figure. That figure.
It's okay. It's okay. No background noise. Yes. What you been doing all my life? Where you been? What's going on?
Oh my God. Well, all right. So I need a bigger house because I'm in a tiny little condo.
Yeah.
So so there's a house I really want. I think I can put the link here. I'll show it to you. Peace.
There's
here it
a
is,
house on
check
a hill.
Check this house out, you guys.
With a woman down with an old mill in a valley below where the river winds. There's no such thing. I'm waiting for the link. So you're getting your house hunting is what you're doing.
Okay. So, and yet, so I get, to get a loan.
Wow,
of course you have to look at that friggin' house.
Oh my God, you wouldn't have no time to clean all that. Well, I would not want a big house. Like that's a beaut. If it came with a free housekeeper, I would take it in a pinch, you know, and a gardener. It's beautiful.
Yeah. But it's, you know, and when I saw it, when you see it in person, it's even more beautiful, you know. It's just, I mean, it's got to be haunted as hell, you know. but anyway, I will worry about that if I can get it. But I'll have Shelby and Renee clear the freaking place out or do whatever. Anyway, so I was floored when I went and looked at it. I was like, oh my God, this is a dream house. It is humongous, 10,000 square feet, 10 bedrooms, a library, built-in library shelf, beautiful. It's just four sun porches, and they're gorgeous sun porches. And anyways, it was just a dream, you know?
400.
Anyways,
it's very economical. $405 per month for gas.
I thought that was. I pay $600 here for my heat.
Oh my God. I would shoot myself in the fucking head. Pardon my language. Sorry. Oops. Beep. Are you kidding me? Like $600. I think I could find a small apartment for $600 a month. $600 for freaking just for heat. I am afraid to know how much lights cost.
Yeah.
How about water and plumbing and lights?
Oh, well, the lights are electric. My heat is electric.
Yeah, but that's an extra amount. But how much is that? Like on top of $600, how much is your lights?
Oh, it's $600 altogether.
You what?
No, it's $600 altogether.
Oh, okay.
But still,
how much is your
that's
gas?
A lot, I think.
How much is your gas bill? Don't you know?
I don't
see,
have gas here.
Just beware that what they're saying to you there is that is just your gas bill, $405 a month. So the water,
but
light.
It's heat.
Yeah, I understand.
No. Okay. Right.
I get that.
Well, anyways,
but I mean,
I figured it out because I would have tenants paying rent. You know what I mean? I know I can do it. I know I can do it. But here's the problem is that my taxes show that I make only $25,000 a year.
Mm-hmm.
So that's so you can't, even though my credit is excellent, it doesn't matter because your tax is everything.
Well, you know, and although it may not help, I mean, all that I can think of right now is that you go with a business plan, then how about operating it as a business, like a bed and breakfast, and then you, it's just like, but it's, but you're, I ain't doing nothing for you people. You know what I mean? Like, it's like it's a bed. So if you, if it's, the other option is to go to the bank and go, like, I have X number of signed up people for a year, you know what I mean? And here's how much rent they're going to pay. And so that's locked in income for me, you know what I mean? And then maybe that helps. But then the bank will go, well, that's for what, that's for 1 year. But you know what I mean? Like, that would be the only thing I could think of that could get you over that hurdle is to have, get, is to get like the, which would be probably impossible to do. You know what I mean? Because you would have to, how many renters would you have?
Right. Only three.
Yeah, three. And how much would you charge them?
Well, see, the second floor has a kitchen. The first floor has a kitchen also. But the second floor has a kitchen, and it's like a whole house, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So I would want, like, $2,000 for that floor, you know?
Right, 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 right. And that's more than the mortgage payment. Right?
No, the mortgage would be $2,800.
Well, it says estimated mortgage. It says estimated mortgage is $1,420.
No, if you put down 20%.
Oh, I see. Okay, well, that's very interesting. Anyways, you could want to talk to the bank maybe and find out how to swing it.
Yeah. But okay, here's the other option is that I need a co-signer, right? So I could do it if I had a co-signer. So I'm talking to my drunk friend the other night, Lisa, and whoops, I shouldn't have said that. But anyways, so I'm talking to her and she's like, I'll co-sign for you. I love you. You're my sister. I'll co-sign for you. And she's like, I just inherited $400,000 and blah, 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 blah. So, you know, I should have known when she came out of her stupor that she was going to renege on it. And she did. You know what I mean? And I was like, geez, you know what I mean? But
how
I wonder, you bring up a
rich
good point, Chris.
How about the rich guy?
I bawled him out because I got into a fight with him about Trump, so I told him to screw off.
Well, go apologize to him and say, I can make it up to you by letting you co-sign for me. It would be my great honor to have you co-sign for me.
Pearl's like, tell him you changed your mind. Pearl, I'd have to grit my teeth to say that.
So anyhow, that's an idea, is to talk to
man.
The bank and talk to, no, he's not a liberal. A liberal is, isn't a liberal like a Democrat? Like, she would have to say she's a Republican, though. But I mean, Donald Trump is not
a conservative.
Yeah, Donald Trump is not a Republican, just so that everybody knows that, right? Everybody does know that, right? Everybody understands that Donald Trump is not a Republican, yes?
Yeah.
Okay. He's like,
I know. He just said he was to get in the race.
Yeah, he didn't even, like, and everyone knows he's not, but he just, like, became one to, you know. He's like a born again, but I mean, he isn't. it's kind of really, but I don't know what the hell could happen in this world that would allow all this craziness to be going on. But it is, and let's don't talk about it, because I'm going to go put a gun to my head or something like that. You know what I mean? So you could go and talk to the bank and see what you could. It is a beautiful house. Too bad that you're in the States and I'm in Canada, because get a few people, you know what I mean? And I wouldn't pay you no $2,000 a month, but I would maybe go in on it and, you know what I mean? Take over one floor, go in on it with you as a co-owner. But I sure wouldn't be paying, you know, $2,000 a month to rent and get nothing out of it. That wouldn't work out well for me. isn't that a beautiful? I don't know. Some miracle could happen. Buy a lottery ticket.
It could happen. But so, and then on the third floor, there's a huge room. You can see it in the pictures. It's the exercise room. My father's warehouse would fit into that room. And that's what I would use that room for, because now I'm renting a warehouse right now, you know?
Wow. Interesting. Interesting. Well, good luck with that. It's a beautiful dream anyway, you know what I mean? But I mean, this would have to happen fairly quickly, you know?
I know. Well, I already have a buyer for my unit. My new best friend, my 88-year-old neighbor.
Yeah.
We shook on it. She goes, I'll buy it when you're ready to go. I'll buy it. And I said, okay.
Wow.
So she's gonna, when the time comes, she's gonna give me what I owe on it, and then she's gonna give me cash on the side. So I'll have the cash to put down on the house. You know.
Yeah. There's a couple ways to go. I don't know how it works in the States, but Marie's talking about writing off your taxes in this. On the business portion, for that would be like 1/3, you know, whatever percentage of square foot that top floor is. You know what I mean? Could be a write off. You know what I mean? And then here in Canada, if you, the beautiful thing, like with a setup like that, the beautiful thing is, now I don't know if it's the same in the States, but in Canada, if I were to have a house like that, let's say, and I could rent out like a whole floor to somebody, whatever, as long as I still live here, I don't have to claim that as income. Now, if I leave here and go live somewhere else and then rent out my condo, then I have to claim all the rent as income. But if I live here and rent out a portion of it, that's just free money in my pocket in Canada. I don't know if it's the same in the States.
I'm not sure, but it is business zoned, Shelby. It is zoned for business. It was, in fact, this is why I know it's got to be wicked haunted, is because it was a rest home for a while. Jesus, right?
It was
a rest home, and then it was, and then it was a fancy clothing shop, dress shop. Yeah. So it is business zoned, oh man. It would just be a dream come true, man, you know? Then you can get grants to help you with your purchase. Okay. Yeah, see, there's stuff that I'm just finding out now, you know, about how maybe I could get it. Oh, you guys, if you walk through this house, you would freak out. I mean, there's 6 fireplaces. Every time I went into a room, I'm like, this is my bedroom. And then I'd go into the next one and I'd be like, no, this is my bedroom. It's like the rooms are humongous. It's just so grand.
How many bathrooms? How many bathrooms are in that house?
6.
Wow. Wowee.
And like I said, those sun porches, you could grow weed on one of the porches. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You could have a garden on one of the porches. They're humongous. You know?
Yeah.
Oh, man. I don't know. You know? Yeah, I would hate to clean them, too. But maybe I'll actually have a maid live there.
Wow. Check this out. In 1994, on September 30th, that thing was sold for $90,000, and then in 2002, it was sold for $267,000. And then in 2009, they tried to double their money and get $489,000, and they didn't sell it. And then it sold in 2014 for $351,000. And
I already offered $300,000.
Well, how can you
offer $300,000? Because my real estate agent told the woman, because the woman wanted to know what we thought of the house, and she said she's willing to pay $300,000 with you paying the closing costs. Because I don't know how much that is. And the lady didn't squawk, you know what I mean? The lady didn't squawk at that. She probably wants to get rid of it. She's a realtor, too. But, I mean, I just think, you know, I don't know. Yeah, it's got a lot of history, Pearl. A lot of history.
Find out on top of that what the property taxes are every year. Because that could be a problem.
Right.
Too. You know what I mean?
I already know. It's $6,000 a year, and I pay $3,000 here. $3,000. So.
Right. So it's like $500 a month. $500 a month.
But that's in with the mortgage. It's the taxes are included in the mortgage payment.
Yeah. Yeah. Interesting. Well, good luck. Good luck. So so that's what's been keeping you busy. What else? I'm not going to say much about it, but I had an interesting, the other day I was talking with a friend and I did an EVP. Then I'm like, want to do an EVP session. And then she had her sister calling her. So I said, okay, go take care of your sister. And then I just decided to just do the EVP session on my own and got some pretty cool stuff, actually. So I can't really play it because it's private. But I'm just teasing. But that was good.
I was going to say to you that we should do an EVP session soon, Chris. Gary, the guy who invented that, I told you, the guy Gary.
Yep.
He was on some show the other night, and it was something amazing happened. What the hell was it? What show was he on? It was some paranormal show. I can't even remember. I can't even remember, but someone sent me the link, but I didn't watch it, you know? Michael, what is an EVP session? Michael, are you serious?
Okay,
that's
I'm gonna
like
play
saying,
so
who's John Lennon.
I'm gonna play for him the miracle of all miracle ones. You know what I mean? That one night when not only did I get the one time with my grandma, like, says my name, and not just Chris, but Kristen. And, like, this is not a coincidence that some radio station was saying Kristen right at that moment that I said, Grandma, tell me my name. But the one night, it was a New Year's Eve, I believe, and I was, like, doing an EVP session here, and I was, like, holding a pen. And I'm like, what am I holding? Pen. I'm like, what? And so, yeah, that was Marie's mom, Penn. That was freaking amazing. Like, it doesn't get any better than that. Are you kidding me? Like, it's like mind-blowing. Mind-blowing.
The one with Konstantin Rodova was the most amazing I've ever heard. And what is wrong with you, Chris? That was an amazing one. That was freaking amazing.
All right,
oh
very good.
Oh, my God. I play that for people and they freak out, you know?
All right.
They freak out. And I freaked out. And I felt that. I think it's awesome. You know, Konstantin Rodova, for those of you who don't know, was the father of EVP. And I knew that if I tried to contact him, because he's come through for a lot of people, I knew if we tried to contact him, he'd come through, and he came through with his German accent. And Chris poo-poos it. I don't know why. She's more impressed with the other ones. But this Konstantin Rodova one was amazing.
He didn't even say his name properly. Like, so I didn't, it's not also what I heard, but anyway, it doesn't matter.
Yes,
why do we have to keep coming back to I'm not ever going to say that I heard it. And what you think you heard is the wrong pronunciation of his name. And I would think the guy would pronounce his own name properly. That's my whole, that's my point. You know what I mean? And,
You never heard him say his own last name.
You're cutting out.
He said he pronounced it Rodova. And that's what his last name is.
Okay. Okay. This is for Michael's
and
benefit.
Then, okay. Well, what about
okay,
the
hang
one?
Hang on.
Okay.
Hang on.
Okay.
So this is for Michael, because he doesn't know what these are, I guess. So this is like the first time I'm using the thing, I think, and I'm asking my grandma, what's my name? And so I've just clipped out this little part. It's like 17 seconds, and I'll stop it when it gets to my name, and then I'll replay it a couple of times for you. And so it's also better if you listen to this with a headset there, Michael. Is he still there? Am I doing all this for nothing? Okay, he's still there. So anyway, here, let's see if you can hear this.
Grandma, if you can hear me, say my name.
Okay, so there it is, right there. I'm going to turn my volume as loud as I can. So my name's Kristen. Did you hear that? Yeah, it's not as easy to play through here, yeah. You heard that. So now let me show you the miracle of then there was the time that who was it? The guy that we used to really like, I think it was that guy that got the promotion and had to stop coming to listen. No, not Christina. It says Kristen. Trust me. There's no ah at all. What was that guy's name? Oh, now I feel bad. I've forgotten it. Yeah, Heath, H-E-A-T-H, Heath. And you won't be hearing nothing when your ears are ringing because I gave you a concussion. Again. Okay, now let me find for you, I'm going to find the Marie's mom. Okay, where's that silly ass folder? There we go. Now, Heath, yeah, there, I could have pretended I knew the name all along. So it would be, let's see here. OK, Okay, 12:31:15 would be, let's see if it's this one. It was right near the end. So let me open this. I know it was right near the end, so, because this was a fairly long one, 6 minutes. But here, let's go to the end.
What am I holding in my hand?
And right there. That's freaking amazing.
Whoa! I heard...
Hang on, wrong. Hang on, let me... I'm going to have to... Okay, let me find that now.
What am I holding in my hand?
And that's amazing.
And
I was holding a pen.
And
is that amazing or is that amazing? That's freaking amazing.
Yeah, it is amazing. So remember the one that I got on my show that said, Corrine?
Yeah, the remember one it? I found for you? Yeah, it was we weren't even trying to get it.
Found.
we weren't even trying to... I was there minding my own business, listening to the archive of that show, and I'm all like, that's an EVP right there. And
Shelby, this is a funny thing, is because everyone who was calling in kept calling me Corrine, and I have to keep correcting everyone and saying it's Corrine, like 5 times, and then suddenly you hear a woman's voice say Corrine, like, you know, and I'm like, it's probably my mother busting my balls, you know what I mean?
But during the show, nobody heard it at all. And,
no.
I posted that somewhere on Facebook. It's on my Facebook, I think. Let me see. Let me go to my Facebook real fast and see if it's there.
Yeah. But you slowed it down, too.
Yeah, I slowed it down. That's the beautiful thing about it, is once you get it, you can do some things. But I always like to keep it in its original. Okay, so now I had to, so it would be in my videos or something, wouldn't it? Videos, video. Video killed the radio star. Let's see. Videos. No. How come I don't see it? What's this? Oh, yeah. This is my...
United States, Donald J. Trump, and the First Lady of the United States, Melania Trump.
The world is yours.
Fun. Okay, that's not the video though, Chris. Stay on task. Oh, this might be it. Where's the... Oh. Nope, that's not it. Hang on. How come? Oh, here we go. This suspected EVP was discovered on Corrine DeWinter's show from Saturday night, August 8th, 2015. Huh, that's my dad's birthday. The timestamp for the EVP is at approximately 2 hours, 20 minutes, 33 seconds mark of the show. The audio file includes a bit of the talk before and after the EVP, with the EVP coming through as it does on the archive copy of the show, followed by just the EVP pasted in three times. This will possibly make it easier for people to hear it. I'm not going to say what I believe the EVP says, so as to avoid leading the listeners into also hearing the same thing, but leave it up to the listener to determine. At this time in the show, there was three participants on the call, and I'm trying to rule out with each of them the possibility that there was any background noise. Now, we did follow up on that, and this was Corrine and her guest and somebody else.
Jackie, right?
Oh, was it Jackie? So if it was like three people and we ruled out any background noise or any other person in the room that could have been making a sound or saying anything. So here. I hope it's loud enough. It's on Facebook.
Well, see, she's just unplugging it on.
Yeah.
So I'll play that again. How can I play that again? Okay.
Well, see, she's just unplugging it.
Yeah.
Corrine.
Well,
yeah.
See, she's just unplugging it.
Yeah.
So there you go. That was the one. Yeah, pretty. That was a good catch. Like, nobody on the show heard it. Like, they didn't. And that's happened to me on my. In fact, there was a couple times on my own show where Bob and I were on, and it was just Bob and I. No, it was just one. I pasted it three times just so that it would be bing, 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 so that you could hear it three times fast. You know what I mean? Every good thing comes in threes, don't you know? And so, there were times with Bob where we had some pretty cool, I wonder if I can find those. This would be in sound files, and maybe I put it in a separate EVP folder, though. Let me just see if I can find. I don't want it there. I look EVP. And then we're going to, if anyone wants a reading, let us know. Barbara's EVP, Lisa EVP, AE, forward EVP and video, Bob? No, I can't find it, and I don't want to waste a lot of time right now looking for it. So anyway, so there you go. That's when an EVP is there, Michael, when all of a sudden out of the funniest EVP story I had, though, was way back at the beginning when I was doing my show way, way back. So long ago when I was young. And,
200.
Huh? 200 years ago. 200 years ago. I had a guy called Ed Yachtman on, and he lives in a houseboat on the water, and we always talk about how, well, we used to always talk about how water is a good conductor for paranormal and things like this. And so, so we did a show, and then the way he did it was he would gather the EVPs, go away for a week, process it all, and then send me the clips, and then I would upload the clips. It was very labor intensive. And so he's freaking out, and he's going, oh my God, I got an open air EVP, which means that he didn't have like the shack hack on or anything like this. It was just like, open air. Kind of like the one that we just listened to on Corrine's show. It just came. It wasn't that we were looking to get one. We weren't using any kind of EVP software or equipment. It just, the spirit just came in and intruded, let themselves be known. And so he's all excited, and so he sends me this file, hey? And I go, I laugh in my head off, and I go, Ed, that's just me going, because whenever I'm thinking, like, I'll go, like, I'll go, that's, I can't even make the right noise now, but, it'll be like that. And he thought he had some great open-air EVP, and it was me. It was just me. Okay, now, let me see. Mary Margaret's there. Are you just listening? Sure. 210, that's Texas calling. Texas Pearl, I'm guessing. And so I'm guessing she's going to want a reading. 360 is Dan the Man. And, yeah. Well, you don't have your hand up, really, Sherry. Oh, yeah, I see up there you do, okay, but not beside your phone. Gotcha. Not me right now. Now you're going to, like, okay, people drive me crazy. Okay, it's a live radio show, and there, that sound. That's the sound. It's a live radio show, and she wants a reading. But she's like, not now, though, for me. Okay, so, like, I'll just put everything on hold there, Texas Pearl, and you just, like, tell me at the precise moment when you're ready for us, okay? And, if you need me, you'll go. If you, when I need you, I just... Anyways, I'm not going to try and sing it. Dan wants a reading. Dan wants a reading. Mary Margaret, what are you doing? Oh, she'll take one in 3 minutes. Everybody's just yanking my chain here tonight. That's good. Sherry, what are you doing? Just listening or you want a reading? Sherry. Sherry wants a reading, I guess. Sherry. Wheels of the bus go round and round.
Yeah,
okay. Sherry wants a reading, so we'll let Sherry go first, since she's the only one not being picky. Oh, now Pearl, as soon as I go, okay, Sherry will go, then Pearl's like, okay, put me in, okay. So Pearl will go second, Dan will go third, because ladies first, right, Dan? And, no, you're not out. What do you mean you're out? You'll be out when I knock you out. And I think that takes care of them. Oh, and Mary Margaret. Well, okay, like what? I'm supposed to know every... Oh, you'll take one in 3 minutes. That's right, Mary Margaret. Okay, so sorry, Dan, you just got bumped by Mary Margaret. That's just my way of keeping you here, Dan, with me. Not that way you can't run away early. Because I want you to stay. Oh, won't you stay just a little bit longer? All right. Just leave the webcam on. I was telling Dan that last time I was on with the webcam, that's all fine. And, like, when I ended the show and that's cool. That sound. Then the next day, I'm sitting here in the morning, and I look like that. Now, I've been looking at my computer for hours. And, like, as I'm looking at the computer right now, in my peripheral vision, like, I can see that the green light is on. But that might just be because I'm, like, I'm, like, aware of it and knowing blah, blah. But so the next morning, I'm all, like, all of a sudden, like, I look, and I'm, like, the green light is on. What is going on? My green light is on. What is going on? Have my camera been on all night? Has Dan been like, what was the word I used? Creeping on me? What is going on? Did the show record for hours and hours and hours and the camera stay? I'm all like, oh my God, right? And I don't know what happened. Maybe it didn't seem like it was it wasn't broadcasting to the show. It wasn't like, I don't know what. Maybe Russia turned it on right at that moment and I caught it right away. And so now I've been like taking my little, because it's just a teeny little one, and like I just take it and off its like little precariously, it's precariously placed there, and then I just like put it face down over there, and it's face down. That's it. And so anyway, okay, let's, so there, we got enough. Now, Corrine does decently long readings, so do you want to take a quick song break and get yourself all centered and grounded and centered and all that kind of stuff, Corrine? Okay.
Are you kidding? No, no, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. I'm on a delay.
What is this
no,
like?
Yeah, oh, that would be good. That
okay,
good.
Very good. Okay, let's do that. I'm going to just like scroll and stop. Oh, my stomach is just like growling again this second. Have you heard about the lonesome loser?
Have you heard about the lonesome loser? Beaten by the queen of hearts every time. Have you heard about the lonesome loser? He's a loser, but he still keeps on trying. You heard about the lonely loser.
Visit purpleplates.com today. For over 40 years, the Purple Energy Plates have been delivering amazing results for their many customers. Inspired by the great genius Nikola Tesla, the harmony, healing, and energetic effects of the plates have proven over and over to be beneficial and often miraculous to thousands of customers. With their money-back guarantee and the many benefits, how can you afford not to get one? Check their site for daily specials and choose from their many energy products. You won't be sorry. Visit them today at purpleplates.com for mind, body, and spirit.
Expect a miracle.
Are you looking for a place to meet like-minded people? Are you a metaphysical practitioner, psychic, medium, or healer, or all of the above? We've got a place for you. IntuiTalks.com. Join for free, listen to spiritual radio shows, get a free website, watch and participate in classes, and so much more. Join the old spiritual, all on the One Roof Network, www.intuitalks.com.
All right, then. We're back. Welcome back. Hello, Kathleen. Last night, Kathleen popped in, and everything was frozen entirely. My Skype was frozen, my page, show page was frozen, everything was frozen. So I didn't even know that Kathleen was here. I don't know how long she was here for, but then I saw that she had been here, and right away, and then she was gone, and then I went, because I refreshed my page, and then I'm like, Kathleen was here, said hello in the chat room, and I'm like, nope, she's not here now. I tried to scoot quickly onto Skype, which was frozen. And the only way I could unfreeze that would be to close it and reopen it, which would have meant that the show would be toast. And so that wouldn't have worked out very well at all. So anyway, hope you had a good day, Kathleen, at your event. And a quick shout out, Texas Pearl, Christine. Hi, Christine. Christy Who is here. You missed. We were playing a couple of EVPs there, Christine. Christy Who is there. Dan, Diane, Kathleen, Marie, Mary Margaret, shame on you. My stomach is grumbling and you're talking about roast beef and everything like that. And I'm like, oh, that would be so nice right now. Michael's there twice. In HTML and in whatever, Flash. Sherry and Corrine DeWinter. And there we go. That's what we got. And me and Dan. Where's Dan? Where's Dan the man? Dan the man. Maybe I said his name twice. Okay, so I did I? Are you paying attention, eh, Dan? Okay, so Corrine is here. Corrine, you ready to rock it?
I think so.
Now, I'm going to say the word, I'm going to say, how are you? And as quickly as you hear it, then I want you to say, I'm fine, okay? Well, or if you're not fine, don't say that. That would be a lie, but you know what I mean.
Okay.
How are you?
Good.
Ooh, that's a bad delay right there. That's a bad delay. So we're going to have to, you guys will have to keep that in mind when you're getting your readings, okay? Because she'll be, if you want to say yes or no, she won't hear it for 3 seconds. How are you?
Good.
Yeah, at least 3 seconds. So that's that, three, so that we can bleep any bad words. And so, okay, let's go. Pitter-patter, let's get at her. Let's go get Sherry. Sherry. Hi, Sherry.
Hi, Corrine.
Okay. Hey.
Hello.
I'm good.
Hello. I didn't ask you how you are. I didn't even ask you how you are. Take it back until I ask you. I'm just kidding. Go ahead. So, how are you?
Good.
Excellent. No delay there. Undelay. Okay. Corrine?
Yeah. Did you have a question, Sherry? I think you had a question.
I had a question. I've got a car question. My car is dying, so I guess I'm looking for a different one. And I'm wondering about the ease of this whole car buying business and if I'll be successful. Or if I spend the money on my car and just get everything fixed.
You know what? I think that it might be better to keep the car you have right now. You know, and it's funny because I wrote down the word boat for you.
Boat?
Oh, boat. My God, boat?
Am I building a boat?
No, but isn't that way back when we had that whole big, long story with the boat with your mom and all that, right?
Me? No.
Oh, wrong person. It's Texas Pearl I'm thinking of. Sorry. My bad.
Okay.
I take that back. I think the boat is for Texas Pearl. Go ahead.
So, it might be. So, anyways, so Sherry, so would it be so bad if you had to keep your current car and just fix it up?
Well, no, I mean, it cost me about $5,000 to fix everything that needs to be fixed on it. That's the only thing. And then I was worried about putting the money into it and then something else happening. And there goes, you know.
Yeah, because you can get another car for $5,000, for God's sake, you know, right?
Right.
All right, so get a new car.
Thank you for calling. Have a good day.
That's my answer.
No, Sherry, can I ask you something? Do you have grandchildren?
No, I have grand dogs.
Okay. Is there an E name that's close to you?
An E name? No. Well, I have a relative. Their middle name is an E name. But he doesn't.
That doesn't count. Okay. And is there a William connect to you?
No.
Yeah, I'm batting zero here. Okay. And the other thing I got for you is bells. Do you collect bells? Do bells have anything to do with you?
I recently made myself a spirit wand and put bells on them. I mean, that's
okay.
A stretch, but hey.
I'm sorry.
No, you know.
I'm sorry. Well, maybe there's no one you know named Bill or William. Nobody?
No. Mm-mm.
Hey, Corrine.
Mm-hmm.
Can you expand a little bit on the E name?
Well, I was gonna say Eleanor, but I'm not sure.
Okay.
You know, I was gonna say Eleanor. Yeah. Ellen.
Okay.
Eleanor, Ellie, something like that.
Okay. No. Not me. I had an E name and a William.
Okay,
Bill,
so
but
Sherry.
Yes.
Okay, so Sherry, yeah, I think at that point, a $5,000 repair warrants a new car. That's that psychic opinion. That's just
that's the way I was leaning too. It's just, you know. All right. Well, that answers that question.
So Sherry, Texas has nothing to do with you?
My brother lives in Texas.
Okay. For some reason, I thought you were in Texas. I don't know why. I know Pearl's in Texas, but I thought you were.
No. Mm-mm.
Okay. Yeah, sorry, man. I wish I could tell you something more.
Okay,
but,
so now zone in on. Yeah. Okay, so now let's refocus on the car. She's gonna go car shopping. So now, try and visualize what car would she keep an eye out for? What color? What kind? What is there anything you can get about that?
Well, I see a white car that's sort of mid-size. It's not tiny. I don't even know what mid-size is anymore, but it's not big, but it's sort of like, you know, halfway between small and bigger. You know what I mean? Like mid-size.
Yeah.
It's got four doors.
Okay, sedan. Okay.
That's what I see her driving in, a white car. Wait a minute. I think it's like $8,000, Sherry. It's like they're gonna be asking like $8,000, but they'll take less, of course, I think. Is there a car lot near you that sells? Is there a car lot near you?
Yes, it's a big, you know, an auto mall or whatever they call them nowadays. Yeah. It's all
Does
different.
Does the word brand. Stevens have anything to do with it? Steven or Stevens?
No, I don't. I'm not sure. I'll have to keep that name in mind.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I see you driving in, a white, it's got four doors, it's a nice car, you know?
Yeah, okay.
I mean, it's not even that old, I'd say it's maybe about five years old, yeah.
Cool. Well, that, keep my eyes open for something. All right, thank you, I appreciate it.
Well, it's nice.
Okay.
It's nice
good talk
to hear
to you
your
too.
Voice, Sherry.
Thank you. Good
All
to
right.
hear you too. Bye.
Good night. Thanks, Sherry. Thank
Bye.
You.
Bye.
So sounds like it's going to be a car lot and not a private, like private call. I mean, a private seller. Okay. Let's go to Texas Pearl. Okay, I'm not having any luck unmuting you. Okay, there you are. There you are. How's it
Hello.
Going?
Hello.
How's it going?
Hi, Pearl.
Hey, Corrine. Miss Super Duper, Purple Plate Lady. So I have a question.
How's it going?
Good. I have a question regarding my middle daughter, and I was wondering what you see going on with her.
You're going to spy
okay,
on your daughter
does,
for a psychic?
Pearl, does...
do I give any background
the name,
information?
Does the name...
There?
No, don't give any information.
No. So does the name Ricky have something to do with her? Ricky? Rick?
Ricky? No.
Yeah. Okay, well, I think you're concerned about some guy that is hanging around with her. Is that correct?
Mm, So I've got three girls, so I'm zeroing on the young. Actually, I'm zeroing in on the youngest. Did I say the middle? I'm sorry. The youngest.
Okay. The youngest daughter. So is it a guy that is in her life that's not very savory?
Not for the youngest. Maybe the middle, but not the youngest.
Okay, so I see your youngest daughter as a free spirit. Like, she's very, she's outgoing, she's got a great personality, she's, I don't know if this is accurate, but I see her as, like, somebody that she's going to do things her way, and she's going to, you know, strike out and just make her own rules, so to speak, and she's great at it. She's, like, she has a lot of friends, she's got a lot of people that love her and believe in her, and she might not be working right now, but she knows what she wants to do, though, I think. Wait a minute. Yeah, she's got a good head on her shoulders. I don't see, you know, I'm not sure exactly why you're concerned or asking questions, but she's not afraid to experiment with things. But I think that's all. I don't think she's going to go out of control in any manner, if that makes any sense.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to explain a little bit, you can, you know.
Okay. So the youngest just changed schools, and she, and I'm wondering, it's affecting her, and I'm wondering if it's just temporary or it'll be long, or it's just not the right place for her.
Okay. I think the new school is better than the previous one. I see her being comfortable there, you know? But like I said, she knows what she's doing. I mean, she's got a good sense. Like, she knows, like, which direction to take at any given time. Is this accurate? Is she got a good head on her shoulders like that?
Yes, that all makes sense. She knows where she's going. She knows what she needs to do. She's just miserable. She doesn't like the environment.
Okay.
She'll do well because she's that type of a person,
But she's only been there a short time, right?
Yes.
So I think if she gives it a chance, like, just, you know, sticks it out for at least another month, that she's going to feel more at home, so to speak, there. And she's going to meet people that make her want to stay there, too. Maybe that's where Ricky comes in. I don't know. I don't know. I see her being okay where she is. I'm not sure why she's miserable there, but I don't know. There's something about that place that gives her another edge to her future that the other place did not. And I don't know. I say tell her to stick it out for at least another month, you know?
Well, she'll be there. for a while. I just didn't know if maybe she should move next year. And yes, this place is better than the last for her long-term degree goals.
Mm-hmm. Right. But she knows she can call you and talk to you about anything. I mean, that's the thing. She's solid. You know what I mean, Pearl? Like, if something's wrong, she's going to tell you. I don't think she'll get into an really uncomfortable situation at this new place. I think that it's for the better. And like I said, I think she's going to meet some people there that really kind of cement her to that, like wanting to stay there. So, you know, but I mean, what are the other options? She could leave now, or what you know, what could
she
do?
She'd have to apply to go to another university. You know, it's very unusual for her to be this unhappy. She's literally crying half of her week away.
Yeah.
So that's unusual for her. So maybe it's just adjusting to being, you know, in a different place for the first time and realizing this is going to be the next, you know, 3 years, or should she go ahead and apply for another university and just change the environment?
Right, right. Yeah, I mean, I would suggest to her, as her mother, to just kind of hang in there for a little bit. And, you know, I don't like that she's crying. Certainly that's not good. But I don't know. I don't know why I feel like this place is worth being at. I'm not sure, you know.
Makes sense to me.
Now, what's with the boat? What happened with the boat?
My mother bequeathed the boat to me. And what Chris was referring to is that I called in because we were having trouble with the boat, and I literally had bees trying to sting me as we were working on the boat, and I didn't want to buy the boat. My mother wanted to buy the boat. And then we had problems with the boat. The boat's been nothing but, you know, a bee sting. So anyway, I still have the boat, and it's just sitting on a lot.
Okay.
So if you know anybody who wants to buy a boat, I'd love to sell the
you
boat.
Might want to take...
You cut out. I didn't
I don't
hear
know any Gillick.
I don't know. The way the weather is these days, it's kind of smart to have a boat in your backyard. You know what I mean?
It's not my backyard. Is the
very
problem?
True. Very true.
You could sell boat. You could sell boat. You could like, man. If I lived in and I had a boat, I'd be like selling rescues. I'll come and rescue you, but you got to pay me. Otherwise, die. I'm just kidding.
Pearl, is there a name on that boat? Don't tell me, but is there a name on that boat?
Oh, I can give you such a flippant answer right now, but you know, I don't know. I don't think we named the boat. Well, unless somebody stole the boat and named it something.
Okay. But there was no name on it, on the back of it?
I don't remember one. What do you see?
Okay. I see Windswept.
Interesting. I'll have to go look.
Yeah. Yeah, so you buy lottery tickets, don't you, Pearl?
No, but I am now.
I was going to ask you to co-sign for my house.
I'll go buy the lottery ticket. If I win something, and I'll co-sign for your house.
Oh. good news.
You wanna throw out some numbers while we're at it?
Yeah, I do. It's 4321. 4321. Play that. Four. You got four daily four there.
I don't know. I don't ever play. So 4-3 what?
4-3-2-1.
I think there's a little crossover with somebody else. So 4-3-2-1, just four numbers?
Somebody else.
Yeah.
Somebody else.
Oh, you. Hi. Hi, Chris. Okay.
Give it a shot. Give it a shot.
Okay. Well, that sounds wonderful. Thank you very much.
Hang on. I got
oh, thank you, Pearl.
Yeah, I'm pulling up something here to. I gotta find something here. Oh, I need it a little bit shorter. I need it a little bit shorter than that. Shorter, shorter, shorter. I'm gonna have to clip one out. Let's see how soon we can find it.
No, I was a little late getting over here tonight. I took the wife and kids out for a ride, and I got lost over in Jersey, you know? Yeah. I'll tell you the way some people give you directions, you can't help but get lost. They always tell me the same thing. Let's go straight ahead. You can't miss it. Just keep going straight ahead. And as soon as I pull away, I come to a fork in the road. Oh, I'll tell you, I had a guy last week. He gave me religious directions. Hey, you ever get these guys? He says, you go down here to St. Anne's Church, make you right. You keep going past Scott Hull. You may.
You know what I'm getting at, right? I can't find the proper spot. Anyway, no respect. No respect. No respect. I get no respect. Okay. All right. Okay, Texas. See you later.
Thank you. Thank you,
right,
Corrine. Thank you, Chris. Bye.
Easy. Somebody else. Like, who the F do you think it would be? Seriously. Somebody else. Somebody else. Okay.
Whoever they are.
Next is, where's that Mary Margaret with the full of roast? How does your barley grow? Okay.
It's tough, Chris. It's still cooking.
Yeah. You ruined the roast? Oh.
No, I didn't ruin it. It's just got to cook longer on low.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Hi, Corrine.
Hello, Mary.
I'm feeling some better. I went to the doctor and she changed my medicine.
I was going to say, you should probably change your meds. You know what I mean?
I feel so much better.
Excellent.
So what are my lottery numbers?
Well, I'll tell you that in a second. But first, I got to say, because I wrote down for you before you came on what I was getting for you, and I wrote down luncheon and also a wreath of white flowers, like which I don't know what that means, but a wreath of white flowers. And to me, that is like just like a kind of a prize thing, you know what I mean? Like that they would give people wreaths if they won like a horse race or something like that, something like that. But I also got that you should not be afraid to take a nap during the day.
Do you ever do that?
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Uh-huh. Yeah, my husband teases.
Good.
Yeah, he teases me about that.
Yeah, that's very good because a lot of women don't feel like they can take a nap. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
See, I don't have to take a nap because I get up at 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Well, I've been playing Publishers Clearinghouse. Maybe I'll win that. Maybe that's what the REAP is.
Oh, maybe, man. Maybe. Wouldn't that be something? That would be awesome. So, yeah, your lottery numbers, you ready? Write this down.
Okay,
you got it?
Uh-huh.
8-7-8-7-3-2.
Gotcha. Okay.
Now, I know you've lost so many friends in the past few months, or in the past year, Mary. You know, there's been a whole bunch of people that you've lost in your life.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love to connect with one of them. But this is the only person I see right now. She's got like thinning brown hair. It's short and it's a little bit curly. And she's not tall, but she's not short. You know what I mean? She's kind of like 5'5" or 5'6" or something.
Okay.
She's got a face like she's been through a lot. Like, I don't know how old she is. She looks like she's in her 60s. I don't know. She could be younger. But she's got, she's also had problems with her teeth, I think. And she was very plain speaking, like very down to earth, and would say what was on her mind. That's who I see in my mind right now.
That sounds like Diane, my girlfriend that died from cancer.
Okay, so did Diane have a son?
Yes.
Okay. Hold on.
Okay.
Her husband, she was married more than once, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. But her husband she had when she died, he's sort of not good right now either. Like, there's something going on. Do you know anything about him right now?
He's got a really bad heart. They've got they had a defibrillator thing implanted in him, and that it's like when his heart stops, it'll go off and shock him. And it's done that since she passed.
Okay. All right. So when I see her in my mind, she's like going, like she's putting her hand, like she's putting her arm, like swinging it back and forth to say, wait a minute, hold on. She's like, okay, back and forth, like up. Like in a pendulum thing. What the hell does that mean? One side and the other side, like from one side to the other. And, yeah, hold on. Diane. All right, so if it's her, Mary, I hate to say that she is doing this or anything because I don't know, but did you guys share food at some point. Like she would make stuff and you would make stuff and you guys would, I don't know if it was cookouts or whatever they were, barbecues or I don't know. I see a bunch of food. Like she's showing me food on a table.
We hung around when we were young and we'd eat at each other's houses, but as far as really, you know, I mean, that's about it. It wasn't like when we were older. We did that more when we were young.
Did she collect things? You know what she collected. Don't tell me, but did she collect something?
Mm-hmm.
Was it some animal? Was it an animal thing?
I'm not, there was something, and I can't remember what it is, Corrine. She did something, but I can't. She was, I can't, if it was like some kind of doll or something, I don't know if I'm getting that mixed up with somebody else.
Okay, because I saw zebras. I don't know why. Zebras.
I didn't hear what you said.
Okay. Zebras?
Weebles?
Zebras!
Oh!
Zebra.
Thank you. Sorry. No, I don't think. That doesn't.
Weebles wobble, but they don't fall down.
She lived on a up by a farm. There was farm animals around her, but that's about.
Okay. Did she smoke, Mary?
No.
No, okay.
She smoked big fat joints is what she smoked.
No, she was really straight.
That's what they all say, Mary. Yeah. Was it?
No, I knew her. She was. She was really straight.
She's down there. She's up there in the bathroom standing on the toilet right near the fan, the exhaust fan.
It's me blowing it out the window.
She's a Bogart. Bogart that thing. She didn't share. She didn't want to tell you because she'd have to share then. She didn't want to share.
Oh, good.
Mary Margaret is passing me along all this. All this. Here, get these seeds. Get that. She's all like hooking me up with the pot, Mary Margaret.
I wondered if you saw it. I didn't see where you said anything. I'm going to start Skyping.
Well, no, half the time, like, same with Facebook. Like, I'll go and the freaking thing is like frozen. It won't let me freaking type in there.
Oh.
And so then I get pissed off and go away.
Well, I got CBD oil.
I wouldn't want to waste my time on that crap.
It yeah, really does I seem just, to help with the pain a little bit. Yep.
No,
I can tell.
I just want to get high.
No, it's
high.
Everybody, let's get
everybody must get stoned.
There's no reason you can't get high now, is there?
Yeah, October 17th. Oh, Corrine, you missed my story. Who missed my story? Everybody, who all missed? Did you miss my story?
Okay. Yeah.
This could only happen to me. So what day is pot legalized in Canada? I just gave you the answer.
October 16th.
No, I just gave it, like, okay, so Mary Margaret has a short-term memory issue.
I do.
I think she smoked a little bit too much. So in all of my life, I love crime, and I love, like, and I always thought, why couldn't I be on that jury? Why couldn't I be on that jury? So there I am minding my own business a week ago yesterday, and I decide, I don't know how long it had been since I had collected my mail. I have to actually open my door and reach my arm out and get the mail, and so I've been, like, letting it sit there, I guess. And so anyway, like, so I grab my mail, and there's, like, this thing from, like, the law courts building. I'm like, what? What? And so anyway, it's a juror summons. Okay, how? Yay! Boo! Because I can make $50 a day, but 30 years ago, I got caught with some drugs, some pot. So I'm a criminal, and therefore I'm ineligible. So why send it to me? So now I had to go through this whole... Now, here's the hilarious thing. Here's the hilarious thing. So, court is going to be the jury day when you go. Let's see if we can get that in focus. The jury day is like the day after they legalize pot. Like, I'm like, oh, like, that could only happen. Like, not that that makes, but I'm just saying, like, just to put a punctuate, emphasis, exclamation point on it all, right? So then I had to fill this whole big, long form out and everything else, and I have to tell them why I'm excluded, and I have to ask to be excused even though I'm excluded. And so then, I had to go through this whole rigmarole of, thankfully we were able to email it, but now I got to find a way to do it. I tried with my webcam and it didn't get a good picture of it. I'm like, okay, well, I got the phone there. I'll try and take a picture of the form and then I'll email it. So anyways, I finally did that. It all took me like a freaking hour. I should bill them for my time, you know? And I sent it, and then, like, yesterday, I'm sitting, like, I'm expected to have, like, one of those automated message things saying, we received your thing, and we'll get to it when we feel like it. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Aaron, is that you, Aaron, from Canada? Aaron? No. Is that you, Aaron? Aaron from Canada.
Aaron.
Is that Aaron? Aaron. Say something in the chat room. I want to know if that's the Aaron, like, that I haven't seen in 6 years or something like that.
It might be Aaron, the other Aaron.
What other Aaron? There is only one Aaron. There's, uh-oh, now there's, like, sirens and flashing red lights. Is that the Aaron from Canada? I want somebody to answer me, damn it. Okay, Aaron. Oh, duh, yeah, okay, well, so, that I haven't seen in 5.5 years, okay. let me finish real quick, and then, because I cut in on your reading and everything. But, so I expected to get an automated thing, I didn't, and, like, they're all like, you have to return this within 7 days. Or under punishment of blah, you know, like criminal, you could be, I'm like, oh, great. Now I'm going to go to jail because I didn't fill the form out in time or something, right? And, at least I'll get fed. And so anyhow, so I phoned there yesterday because I'm like, oh, like, what the hell? And then I'm all like, what? Here's going to, watch, this is going to be my luck. You watch this. This is going to be my luck. So I sent in the form, but I don't know if they got it. And I sent it again yesterday, and I still didn't get an automated response saying they received it. And so, but here's what's possibly going to happen. They're going to go, we can't find no criminal record. And I'll go, well, yeah, I do have a criminal. And they'll dig a little bit deeper, and they'll go, oh, well, we'll have to make sure we enter that. And so anyway, like on the upside, like the one thing that they could do, like then I'll go, well, maybe I was 30 years ago. Maybe I like, maybe I got just paid a fine. You know what I mean? And so anyhow, like, and maybe I don't have a, maybe through some try, maybe for all these 30 years, I've been like operating like I have a criminal record and I don't, like I do, but I don't. And so anyway, but wouldn't it just be the funniest thing if that they go, oh no, you weren't entered in the system, but now we see our error, so we'll get right on that and we'll enter it. You know what I mean? Like, I'll be like, oh my God, you gotta be kidding me. So, but how, I would love to have been on a jury. The end. Sorry.
That's funny. So, you got anything else, Corrine?
Yeah, Mary, did Diane read the Bible?
Yes.
Okay, so she's pointing to a place in the Bible. Do you have a Bible?
Yes.
Okay, so I want you to turn, you don't have to do it now, but turn to page 219 in the Bible and read the first few lines on page 219.
I don't have it here with me.
No, that's write okay. It down.
No. Oh,
do it on your own. Don't do it. Don't be reading no Bible on my time. You do that on your own time.
Okay.
219.
Okay.
And I'm also going to say to you, the reason I wrote down luncheon for you is because someone's going to... You're going to be involved in doing something with a luncheon or some kind of lunch get-together. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure what it is, but I don't know. I don't know why it keeps hearing luncheon or lunch. I don't know. I'm not sure what it is. But anyways, look out for that. You know what I mean?
Well, we were talking about that today, or yesterday, me and my girlfriend. Hmm.
What were you saying?
I said we were talking about going to lunch, shopping and going to lunch. Are
okay.
You saying?
I think it's bigger than, yeah.
Bigger than that?
Bigger than just you and a friend. It's like a luncheon that someone has that you're involved with. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. I'll watch for that.
Yeah, definitely watch for it. Other than that, you know you're so loved and appreciated, and the love that you spread is so important, and you can never, ever, ever forget that.
Aww. Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah, and you know that, right, Mary?
Yep.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I'm feeling better now. I was just really down and out for the last, oh God, month, 2 months.
It's brutal. It's brutal.
Well, thanks, Corrine. And Chris, interrupt my reading.
Yeah, I know. I'm kind of rude that way sometimes. You know what I mean?
And just a pot story.
Over a stupid pot story.
Okay, I better be quiet before my husband kills me.
Okay.
Thanks, you guys.
You mute your damn self, and Dan, unmute your damn self. Thanks, Mary Margaret. Thanks for playing. Me. Hello, Dan. How are you doing, young man?
I'm doing fine.
Aw, that's good. It warms my heart when you...
Sorry, I don't mean to talk over you, Chris.
No, you can't help it. You're on a delay.
The last time Dan was on, he was asking about his job. and I said the job was going to be okay. I couldn't see anything changing. So tell us what has happened since, Dan.
He got fired, and he's gotten thrown in jail because he punched the boss in the nose for doing firing him.
No, I would never do that. No, actually, things are working out. Troublemakers are kind of being, people are aware of it now. How's that?
Mm-hmm.
Management is aware of who's the
good.
People
that's
with
good.
The steering stick and what they're doing. Yeah, so it's, mm-hmm. So I feel safer now. Feel a lot
awesome.
Safer.
Right.
Still hate my job, though.
So then, the protesters, they weren't protesters, they were...
Oh, the strike. The guys that were on strike. Yeah, we only had reduced hours for maybe 2.5 weeks.
Right.
Then we're back at it.
Yeah, that's what I thought was going to happen, and I told you so. I said, that's not going to last very long. Anyways, so here's what I have for you, Dan. Did I ask you about someone named Cindy before?
No.
Okay. Do you know a Cindy?
Couple of them.
Several. Okay. And I also get that, did you just cut down a tree or something? Is there some tree that's giving you problems in your yard?
Well, actually, there's one the neighbors pushed towards the house when they cleared the land. It's bothering the hell out of me, actually.
Okay. Well, so you got to get rid of that. All right, so let's talk about Cindy. Is one of the Cindys you know important to you in any way?
Oh, yeah, you could say one of them.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Is she, because I see a woman in my mind that I think is Cindy. Anyways, does she have like brown, reddish hair, like sort of red highlights in it?
Yeah, she did.
Okay. Are you still in love with her, Dan? Are you still in love
with
her?
Oh, God, no. 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 Different kind of important.
I'm just busting you. I'm busting you. Okay. Well, anyways, I don't know why that came up. But anyways, other than that, let me see. Do you have any questions, first of all?
Yeah, I've kind of felt someone around me lately, and just kind of wondering, you picking up on anything?
Okay, interesting. And you've been having dreams too?
Yes.
Okay. Would your grandfather make sense?
Maybe.
One of your father's father? Your father's father?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, actually either one. But.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Definitely positive. Not a negative, it's a positive.
Yeah, right. It's kind of like strength for you in some ways. You know what I mean? Like there's a certain amount of strength that you get from that, you know, from him being around. It's almost like he's saying, I understand what your, you know, your thoughts and your, like, cause you kind of like him, I think, in a lot of ways. I don't know. It's like, I have this weird thing in my mind right now about you and him. and how he is paying attention to what your path is and what you're going through. And he wants to say, yeah, you know, I like watching your life. I like watching what's going on right now. And I'm kind of cheering you on in a way, you know. I don't know if, I don't even know if you were close to him or what, but there's some kind of connection there, I think, you know.
Yeah, when I was younger, pretty close, but then we moved around quite a bit. And I think last time I saw him, I was probably 12. Yeah, but kind of weird to pick him, though, because I just...
Okay.
I just got a M1 Grand that belonged to him. It's on my gun safe. And just about the time... Kind of weird. I didn't put that together, but yeah, just about
really?
The time I got that. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't...
Mm-hmm.
Didn't notice
yeah.
that until now.
Right. So, can you tell me his name? It wasn't Edward, was it?
No. What was his middle name? I'm wondering if that was his middle name. No, it's Kurt.
Kurt. Okay. Okay. Yeah. When you said Kurt, I was like, okay. I mean, it seemed to make sense to me, you know what I mean? Like, it was, I don't know, I can't explain it to you, but I see this connection. It's like when I see your grandfather and I see you, it's like there's this blue ray of light between you guys. I can't explain it, but I see, like, I'm looking at my wall right now, but this is what I'm seeing, your grandfather and you, and this blue light between you, like, yeah, I'm connected to him. I'm here. You know what I mean? Like, I'm watching him. And he kind of knows the way that you react to things, like your emotional being of, you know, what you go through. And he's saying that, I hate saying he's saying because I don't know if I'm talking to your grandfather or not, but if it's him, he's saying that he was like you in the way that he didn't, he kind of kept things close to it, to the vest, and he didn't like willingly share things with other people. Like he was sort of private, very private, and but he says, you're more open than he was, but you're still not open enough. I don't want to say not enough, but you're still not as open as you could be. And, but he's glad that you recognize that he's there. He wants you to know that he is there, you know? Was he very private, Dan?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay. Definitely.
Yeah. So interesting. His wife, which would be your grandmother, she's on the other side too, correct?
Oh yeah.
Okay. Was her name? Did it begin with an S?
M. M.
M. Mary. Okay. Was Mary? Mary. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah, she's with him too. And when I'm now, he's like he holds out his arm and she comes and takes his hand and okay. All right. So what do you want to tell Dan? What do you want to tell Dan? We're just watching. We're just watching.
They're creeping on you, man.
They do shuffle some things around for you as they're able to. But they say that, Dan, they say this too. They say that you're lonely, even though you're married. You're there's something about you that is like you have this lone wolf sort of thing about you, like that you feel like you're on your own. You know what I mean? That's what they're saying. We recognize his not loneliness, but lonely, like the way he is, like. You know, just like a loner type, even though you're married. I know you're married, but there's some kind of loner thing about you. I don't know if that's true.
I'm going to be like in a headline for the neighbors. Are going to be talking about how quiet I was.
That's what I hear right
now. He seemed like such a nice guy.
No, he's quiet. Kept to himself.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Maybe I should take his rifle out.
That's probably why they're... No. But I mean...
But my psychic told me to.
Oh. I think that they're saying...
He didn't say lone gunman.
I had to do it.
No, but I mean, I don't know if it's because you're, but Dan, maybe you're reflective, and you said you're quiet and reflective, and introspective. Perhaps that's what they're talking about. You know what I mean? I don't know. But they're also talking about. So they had a daughter too. Did they have a daughter too?
My mom, the mom side, the one I got the rifle from.
I thought I said it was your father's side. Did I say it was your mother's side? I thought I said father's.
Oh, I thought it was mother's, but hey, father's? No, a bunch of boys.
Like all boys?
Six of them. All boys. There's like five or six of them. Yeah.
Oh, shit. Okay.
No, they're not Mormon.
They're talking about a girl.
Okay.
So did your father's parents have a girl?
No. Nope. Did not. What are they saying about the girl?
All boys?
Nope.
Oh shit. Well, maybe it's like a girl that wasn't born that, you know, who knows? She could have had a miscarriage or something, you know what I mean? I don't know. Anyways, it's a girl. All right, maybe that's what they're trying to say is that the girls, I have no idea. I don't know. I'm no Renee Richards, but, okay, so let me try to get one more message. Hold on. Even though I didn't even really give you a message. Hold on. I did give you a message, but. Okay, so the way you make meat all the time, they're like, but he doesn't put it in lasagna. Why doesn't he put it in some Italian thing? Lasagna. You make lasagna ever?
No, I don't. But my grandmother on my mom's side made like the best, so.
Yeah, she says, put the meat in the lasagna. For God's sake, Dan, make some lasagna.
Yeah, if I get the time. Oh, yeah.
Ooh, with smoked cheese. I've never had, that would be interesting, smoked mozzarella in the lasagna.
Yeah.
That would be nice.
Awesome.
I know.
The whole
thing on this. Yeah, there you go.
Just cook it in the smoker. But back to the girl. You got my curiosity going. What was with the girl?
Okay. It seems like they were trying to say something about the girl. I thought it was their daughter. But it's not their daughter. I don't know. She's, I can see her, but she would have been born in like the 1950s. I don't know. So you don't know if they had, like, if she had a miscarriage or not, right?
I don't know. I wouldn't know.
So you could ask your mother, but she won't tell you, right? Or you're not talking to her.
Oh, my mom? Yeah, I could ask her, but the dad's side of the family, I'm not going to get any information about that.
No, okay. Yeah, ask your mother for the hell of it, you know what I mean? Yeah, it's just a girl.
Description or a...
Yeah, she's got like she's got brown hair and it's like pulled back. She's wearing and the reason I say she was born in the 50s is because I think that, well, she's not wearing modern clothes. She's kind of wearing like a cardigan and a shirt under the cardigan and a skirt. And her hair is kind of pulled back a little bit. She's pretty, though. She's got big eyes. Shit. She is their daughter. She just said, I am their daughter. I'm their daughter. And the name Rebecca, I don't know if they ever named her. Probably not if she was never born, but... The name Rebecca. Does that sound familiar at all, Rebecca?
Sort of. Yeah, I'm trying to think
okay,
where I know that name from, but yeah, it's kind of weird. I had to walk in the back room here. My wife had a miscarriage. Guess what the fucking name was? Oh, sorry. But, yeah. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, my God. Maybe it is her, Dan. But
well,
why would she... I don't know why I would see her in that outfit. And she wouldn't... All right, so if that little girl... survived, she would only be like 12 now, right? Or 10?
A little older.
That's how old?
Oh, God. Let me think. Oh, man. I can't remember because we're just stone. March. I can't see the year.
Doesn't really matter because
yeah.
they always, I mean, remember they say they go to the age 30.
Yeah.
Like, because they're like, so it doesn't have to be. Since the baby wasn't born, then there's like, I would always say that a spirit will come in the way that you would best recognize them, but since the baby wasn't born, you know what I mean? Then there would be no, you know,
yeah.
So then maybe the default age is 30 for ghosts.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
But Dan, Kathleen's saying 13. Does that make sense?
I'll be back.
Jeez. I'm not too sure. I mean, I don't want to ask her because it's just kind of a bad subject.
Right. So, I mean, you don't remember when this happened? Was it 20 years ago? Was it... You don't remember?
I don't remember. I'm thinking it's got to be at 20-ish, maybe a little less. God, she just okay. Said, hey, okay. Like she, well, March, she's like, she would have been. Yeah, God, I can't remember.
Okay. But around 20.
Yeah, give or take a few years.
Yeah. Okay.
So that's her family, what I'm feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what I'm getting?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So if
yeah.
she said to me that I'm their daughter, it could be said to you. You know what I mean?
Oh. Their daughter. No, that's... you got me scratching my head. The name kind of
okay.
really was like, holy cow. But, daughter. Yeah, that's, you got me scratching my head. I don't know about the daughter thing. It's her daughter. Huh. Yeah, I don't know. It doesn't make sense. Because it was...
So it wasn't your... So it wasn't your child that she lost?
No.
It was another?
No. Yeah. Yep.
Okay. All right. Okay. I see. Well, does your wife look like what I described?
Yeah, if the, oh, this is kind of funny, but I think her hair is blonde, but it's, after the chemo and radiation, it kind of all went to gray, right? Yeah, so.
Okay.
Yeah,
yeah.
Before that, she had like this strawberry
okay.
blonde thing going though. But I know.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
Thought of it. Five is brown hair.
Does your wife have big eyes?
Well, the daughter that's alive does. Kind of comparing that, but that's
okay. Mm-hmm.
Kind of weird.
Yeah.
So, a little something I wasn't going to say anything about, but wife had a stent put in a couple weeks ago, her heart, and on the CT, they noticed a new nodule in her lung, and like this fog across
oh.
the chest.
Yeah.
Things have been a little stressful, and I mean, really, I'm supposed to be like
I'd say.
Rock solid for everyone. Have anybody talk to you? Have
yeah, yeah.
Little moments of holy crap, but yeah. So it's been stressful. So if it's like her parents, I don't know if her parents had a daughter that didn't make it. I don't want to ask. It seems it would make sense that they're kind of around and positive, reinforcing things.
Yeah. Right. Or if they're with her daughter. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. It's that would make sense. But, yeah, it's, I don't know. It's just been a little stressful. And I just say, notice that I've had a friend lately. Yeah, it's
yeah.
I got this new fit
now,
thing.
Has
keep track
she,
of my sleep.
Has she?
Oh. Go ahead.
Yeah. Has your wife gotten tests for the things that they saw?
Monday. That will happen Monday.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, that's why you're feeling that. That's why you're feeling them around now, I think. You know what I mean? I'm not sure, but I think that's one of the reasons. Shit. I don't know. I hate to hear that, but it might not be anything bad either, Dan, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, it's going to be what it's going to be. But
right.
It's going to be scar tissue is what I'm thinking.
That would be good.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm hoping. Then again, scar tissue goes on a PET scan too, so it's not as bright.
Right, right. Yeah, that freaking scar tissue, that can cause problems too, but I mean, you know, at least they can get that out or correct it, you know?
Or just leave it alone. It's just scar tissue. That silkworm enzyme for that. Yeah.
Right, right.
Yeah, but... I've got this Fitbit thing, keeps track of my sleep, and I haven't been really getting that much sleep. The dreams seem a lot longer than the sleep I've been getting. You know what I mean? It's kind of weird. I mean, you think I've been asleep a lot longer.
Right. I hear ya. I hear ya.
You didn't ask me, but I'm looking at your wife ahead, and
I don't see anything horrible happening at all. I see some things she's got to take care of with this, but it's not like a horrible thing. So I'm going to keep her in my prayers and hope that this, you know, is okay.
Me too.
Me three.
Thanks, Chris.
No problem. She has to be okay, because otherwise you'll be coming to Canada and bugging me.
Yeah. I don't know if they'll let me in. I have this little weed arrest. It was in the national park.
Okay, good night,
Aaron. So federal.
I bet I missed Aaron. I missed Aaron.
Oh, wow. 5 minutes.
Yeah. It was good to see Aaron here tonight, you know?
People just, like, drop in at the funniest, because tonight we had a few drop-ins of people that I haven't seen in a long time. Must be because of you. They must have seen you on the feed or something like that. You know what I mean? Know what I mean, Corrine?
Yeah.
I made a rhyme.
Yeah, I try to cultivate. Friendships where I can. Cindy Plume was gonna come tonight too, but she's like, "I'm so tired, I can't make it." I said, "Don't worry about it, man." You know.
Wow, I haven't heard from her in ages too.
Yeah. Yeah, so Dan, try not to worry too much about it and try to get some, you know, good sleep. I know you haven't been sleeping well, but try, you know. And know that your grandfather is freaking holding you, you know. I mean, know that, because I really believe that it's him, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I got boiling.
Oh, shit. Did you say shit on our show?
She said shit.
At least you didn't.
She said, oh, shit. My pasta's boiling.
Burning her lasagna? Giving it that smoky flavored?
She's burning her lasagna.
Yeah, the sawdust. Yeah. Oh, shit.
Smoke coming into the camera.
Yeah. So the Cindy woman, did the Cindy, I mean, what did she mean to you? Any of these Cindys mean anything to you?
Well, one was my best friend's ex-wife, and the other one was a friend of my wife and I's who now has health issues and don't see her too much. Cindy? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh my God,
yeah.
Now my wife's asking me if I had an affair with her. Really? You've been talking to Corey? Because Corrine asked if I still loved her.
Oh, shit.
God, I can't catch a break.
No, you can't.
Ooh, now she's threatening to break my nose.
That's funny.
You know, this is being recorded, and this could be brought up as evidence in court later
on. It could be. It could be. I don't see. Oh, it is. Okay. I didn't see that it was being recorded, but it is. Yeah, we better nip it in the bud here. You know what I mean? Yeah, so I've been reading some interesting books lately about, you know, of course, my favorite subject, life after death. And this one book I'm reading right now called The Hand on the Mirror is by this lady who was she was like a newspaper lady for years, and her husband died, her second husband died, and she wakes up on the anniversary of his, you know, the first anniversary of his death, and she sees this handprint on a mirror in her bathroom, and it's kind of like powdery and whatever, and she's like, she doesn't believe anything that she sees for like the first year, although all this stuff is happening. You know what I mean? And so finally, getting toward the end of the book, she starts to believe, because another handprint came on the second anniversary, and then a footprint on the couch, and all this other stuff starts happening. And she gets remarried, and she starts investigating life after death, and she goes to see all these experts on life after death. And so that's when it gets interesting, is when she's telling the stories about going to see the guy at Monroe Institute and and Dean Radin, who's a big psi guy, and all these other, you know, kind of well-known names in the field, and she starts, like, so she tells what they tell her and what they say to her, but it, like, at first I was like, this is boring, you know what I mean, this lady's a newspaper reporter and this is freaking boring. But then I kept reading it and it got more interesting as she started to investigate and believe in it, you know what I mean? But anyways, it's just, you know, so anyways, whatever. I've been reading. Put some beans on to cook, and I boiled it over and made a heck of a... I thought you had pasta on the stove, Chris. Okay. What kind of beans?
Navy beans.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So Pearl said that earlier. She's psychic.
What did she say?
She said, time for navy beans.
Oh, did she? Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny, because I had them, I didn't see that, but I had them soaking since this morning, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I got to soak some thick peas, you know?
So, oh, yeah, I love that. No, yeah, like, I love that. I thought I had some, because then I can make my own... instead of using the canned crap, you know what I mean? You can make some nice hummus.
Oh, totally. Yeah, yeah. I know, I love that. Shit.
But you I also have some naan bread dough. So I'll be able to make some naan bread after. So hungry, oh my god. I've been wanting to go back, go get a bunch more groceries, but with all this snow, like I'm all, how ridiculous am I going to look like lugging my luggage down the road in a snow, in a snowdrift? My
how
little
much
roll
snow
away.
Did you get?
Like, it's been snowing, like, almost every day at some, since the middle of the month. Like, the snow, like, I mean, it's not snowed, like, but I'm just saying, you know what I mean? What a mess.
Wow.
But, like, it's stayed on the trees and the roofs, and, like, it's, like, not like that. It's snowing and melting. It's, like, staying.
Yeah.
Staying. And so that sucks.
I wanted to ask you about something, but maybe we should do it after. If you want to do overtime, I understand if you're tired. But I wanted to bring up something about Justin Trudeau that another Canadian said to me, and I wanted to ask you what you thought of it, but I don't want to say who it is unless we're not recording.
Okay. We are recording.
Mm-hmm. Right.
All right. Well, what's the thing about Justin Trudeau? You don't have to say who said it.
That he's a jerk. That he's made all these bad decisions.
No. I think that would be a question of political line. You know what I mean? If you're not, like,
yeah.
I think that would be more to do with political preferences.
Right.
He's good. Everything else aside, even if he's as much of an asshole as Trump, he looks way better.
Yeah, no kidding. No kidding.
And he legalized pot. And he legalized. I don't give a shit what else the guy does. He legalized pot. You know what I mean? Like, I'm all good with that. That's fine with me.
Yeah.
No,
I know.
Like, I really think that's the situation. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean.
No matter who you talk to, you're going to find someone that's going to criticize whoever's running whatever country. You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah. Also, one of the complaints from this person was that he showed up at the LBGT, whatever it is, performance, and he was all, like, into it, and I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, who cares? You know what I mean?
Well, to
and
me,
then
that,
I realized,
that's that's showing somebody else's own prejudice. In fact, it sounds to me like somebody could turn around and not like somebody just because they, like, if you are gayophobic or whatever, you know what I mean? Like, okay, like LGBTophobic. If you're, like, so dead set against that and then you see your prime minister supporting them, that'd be enough right there to make you, like, look dimly upon everything the guy does. Know what I mean? If you're hardcore
mm-hmm.
prejudice against, right? So that I think I know who
right.
it is you're talking
right.
about anyway.
Okay. That was
it's really disturbing.
Yeah.
Nah, and like that, like, you know what? Like, I'm going to just say it to you like that. Like, somebody that's going to say they have a problem with their prime minister showing up to support the LGBT community, and that upsets that person, says a lot about that person, you know?
Totally.
And
yeah,
so anything
totally.
Else they have, anything else they have to say in terms of their opinion about that guy that was supporting that group, I don't need to hear, because the word is eluding me, but anyhow, I'll just use the word asshole instead, because that's an easy one. But you know what I mean? Like, they're
right.
they're prejudiced against it, and that's skewing everything else. You know what I mean? It's but I still can't understand in this day and age, right? Okay, like there's a thing. There's a, like if somebody like, it kind of bugs me, but like what? It's not the end of, like I don't get all worked up about it. That's different than these people that are hardcore haters, right? And I don't. It doesn't affect you, right? Like it doesn't affect
right.
you. Same with. Like I was saying. Now I'm gonna get on a roll for a second. Like I was thinking the other day. These people are pushing so hard to get this jerk into the Supreme Court, okay? And they don't care what he's done, that he's lied under oath. They don't care about any of that as long as they can overturn Roe v. Wade, right? And take away the rights of a woman to have an abortion. So I was thinking, like, would serve these bastards right? Like, let's make a law that says men are not allowed to have vasectomies, and any one of them that has had a vasectomy has to have it reversed. That's the law. And you know, go and if you don't, like, and you better report back. No, all those guys, how many of the guys that get vasectomies, and here's my reason. So you're pro-life, right? So a little sperm is alive. It swims. It's alive. It's alive. Okay? Little sperm is alive. So what they're doing is that they're, with malice and forethought, they're undergoing a procedure that will cause harm to those live sperm. They're hurting the little guys. They're breaking their tails off. They're making them jump to their deaths. And that is cruel and inhumane. And so the second thing is, how many of those guys that get vasectomies are getting vasectomies because they're cheating on their wives and they don't want to get the other woman pregnant, right?
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
Yeah.
And So all I'm trying to get at is, how would the men like it if there was a law like that, right, that took away their right to be able to get a vasectomy?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of guys wouldn't care because they don't want to have anything to do with the snip snip. But the ones that do, they have a reason. They want to just be screwing everything that moves, right? Not have to pay alimony or child support. But I'm getting an exaggerated argument, which is to say, it is true that a sperm is alive, right? No. If I understand I have grade 9 science, right? But we have an egg that's not a lot, like that's nothing until it gets fertilized, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? So it's the little live, little fishing, little swimming, little fishy, little sperm guy, right? That's without that, there is no life, right? And they're killing the
right.
live sperm.
Right.
They're killing them. They're murdering. So everyone, they're murdering them. They're murdering the sperm. And they're calling themselves pro-lifers. Huh. My point is simply that men wouldn't want anybody dictating to them what they could or couldn't do. In regard to that, right? It's the closest comparison I can come with, but the added argument that those sperm are alive, they are alive. They're alive. Isn't that
they
the whole
vote.
Premise? Well, neither can a fetus. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yep.
And, you know, so... But so anyhow, I just like... Because something, these men need to have something that shakes their heads to say, like, what business is it of yours? It doesn't affect you. Because on the other hand, you force them to have their babies and then you bitch and complain because they're on the welfare. And then you cut the welfare so that you can get a few more billion dollars in tax grabs for your rich guys.
I think a better law would be to keep religious beliefs out of our laws, you know, out of the government. In a free country, you shouldn't be forced to follow someone else's religious beliefs.
Well, put all the religious, put all them religious people in their own state then.
Who?
Let them have Texas.
That's only the financial stuff.
I know.
Separation of church and state.
Or let them have, what's the one that has the Mormons?
Utah?
It's
Utah.
Let's send them all, every religious freak. Like, and I don't mean just that you're religious. I mean that you're an extreme religious zealot. All those people have to go to Utah. That's a good law. Right? That's a good law. I think that's a good law. But anyhow, like, don't you follow my logic on the whole thing of the men?
Yeah, I gotta give them something to think, take away their choice or their right, just like they're taking away everybody else's.
Bastards.
Yeah.
Bunch of old white men. Bunch of old white men. Bunch of old white men. And then how many times did they... How much did they find out? How many times did they find out that these guys that are hardcore and voting against and blah, 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 that they paid their mistresses to have abortions? Right?
Yeah.
Oh, I wouldn't get so carried away just yet, and it might be good if he does. But don't count the chickens before they hatch just yet. You never know. He was supposed to be appointed by now. And already, like, there's some, like, shakiness going on. And so it's interesting, to say the least. I think God is intervening, to be honest with you. I think God is intervening. That's what I think.
Yeah. A lightning bolt hits one of them, or a meteor hits one of them.
Well, no, like, I mean, it, to me, I just find it fascinating that, and then there could be some other thing now that happens that's not even associated with this allegation, like some other big crisis thing that comes up that even prevents any of these people from actually doing the vote. You know what I mean? I think God is intervening. God does not want that guy in the Supreme Court. So there. Now we turned it all into that, and that's all Corrine's fault. All because she wanted to talk about Trudeau. You see how quickly we can, like.
And you don't even know what happened when you weren't here that night that I had the show last time.
Oh.
And I don't want to explain it to you unless we're. I don't want to explain it to you unless we're not recording, because something happened that was pretty, so unless we're not recording, I can't talk about it.
No, we are recording. We are recording.
You're thinking you should stop recording. The second time she's mentioned it, maybe I'm being sensitive, but...
Well, it's time to go soon here. So I'll stop recording for a couple minutes, but I do have to get going here pretty quick. So let me just look and we go. Wednesday, Kathleen is here, guys. Wednesday, and so if I'm not under a snowdrift by then. So thanks all you guys in archives for listening. Sorry to turn it into craziness at the very end. Other than that, it was good. I haven't gone off on politics in a long time. I haven't had a show in a long time. Anyway, I'm doing very good, I think, avoiding this. You know what I mean? And not going too crazy about it. Because it is, like, very devastating for me to see what's going on over there every day. Oh, my God. It's absolutely devastating. I can't believe this. I cannot believe it. Mm-hmm. But anyhow. It is what it is. So, okay, where's Amy? Amy popped in last night, and then she bailed after a while.
I'm here.
Oh, Amy's there. Where the hell are you?
I went out.
Oh, you're there. Okay, let me stop recording. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Amy. Happy birthday to you. And many more if you want them.
Right, exactly. Thank you. If I want them. Sorry, I was interacting with the enough to get hot chocolate because it's freezing here, but at least it's not snowing.